saw me doing my shower kit backstage.
Oh my goodness.
I thought that was sort of like, I knew who Jim Henson was. The Muppets weren't big by any means at that time.
Oh,
I saw them
goodness.
All at Sullivan and other shows. And so it was though if I was a drummer, some fellow came along, so I looked at the
button.
You know, Jim told me he wanted me to play two characters. One described the bird, and the bird initially was going to be just a silly, goofy bird.
It is.
And
okay.
The other was Oscar the
Grouch. Do you want to call me when you get
settled? Yes, I have a question.
I'm free tonight. Yeah, I'm free.
What
is the capital? Just call me when you get home. Yep, okay. I'll talk to you in a little bit.
The cab and got in. The guy says, "Where to, Mac?" So I said, "Wow, what a great voice." He had a cigar on one side of the mouth, and the voice came out the other like this. And I said, "That's perfect." So when I got out of the cab, I kept saying, "Where to, Mac? Where to, Mac?" I'm trying to learn to do this voice, but I couldn't imitate that very well. He really sounded a lot like that. I had never tried that. I swear if I hadn't looked at him, seeing him talking out of the corner of his mouth in his rearview mirror as I'm sitting over. And so I got Oscar. It was from a woman who had a little 4-year-old boy named Christopher, and she heard sniffling. Big Bird was in the scene where he was the only child around, and so he was very sorry for himself because all the kids had gone off to school, and he was too young. And so she hears Christopher watching the show, and she's busy in the kitchen. She hears a little sniffling and crying, and she goes, "What's wrong, Christopher?" He said, "Big Bird's just like me. All alone all day because the kids, his older brothers and sisters, were off to school." And so he saw himself and actually identified with Big Bird, who was, you know, hardly an ordinary looking child. The bird became, as I said earlier, he was, Bird was really a goofy guy. And when I decided he should be a child, and the producers thought that was a good idea as well, I started going higher with his voice.
Hi there. Until I got up here, I'm trying to be a kid. Let's see. It says, "Welcome to Toadstool, the Mushroom City. The Mushroom City, annual tournament of Mushroom Parade."
It was really fun to sit in the theater join me? I thought that was sort of like, no, I knew who Jim Henson was. The Muppets were big by me at that time, but I saw them a lot of Dan Sullivan and other shows. And so, if I was a drummer, some fellow came along and said, I'm going to the band. Would you like to meet me drumming then? You know, because to me, if there's a Beatles in the puppet world, it was the Muppets. Jim Henson was a very humble self, very interested in other people, and I never saw him angry. I'd see him upset, but he never reacted against it. And one day, when I was in the early days of the show, if I wasn't as disciplined as he and Frank Oz were doing, and we were doing the first scenes of Sesame Street, little scenes where with the Anything Muppets, where they could put different eyes, different wigs, make a little kid or a dragon, and I kept missing the opening note with the lip sync, and I missed. They'd say, so everyone likes ice cream, you know, it's one of my problems. And so we were watching playbacks, and the third time I had still been wrong. And Jim, one of the bars watched the playback, and so he saw an empty one over on the other side. And he walked over to take a look at that myself, and he didn't see me walk up behind him. And I heard him quietly say, garbage. And it went like a knife through me. I said, oh, God. I said, Jim, I'm sorry. I'm going to resign. I'm not good enough to be a Muppeteer. And he turned around and turned me.